Welcome everyone and welcome to my garage. I am Flo, the creator of Notis.ai, and today I'll show you step by step how to get started with Notis. But before we get on with that, why not like and subscribe so that I can know you want more in-depth tutorials like this. So today we're talking about Notis, and if you just stumble on this video and don't know what Notis is yet, it's an AI assistant that runs directly on WhatsApp and use your voice to capture, organize, but also retrieve anything in your Notion workspace. Simply put, if you're someone that doesn't sit at their desk all day, it's the only way to be productive on Notion, no matter where you are and what you do. Now, let me show you how to install it. So first, you would want to launch your browser, open a new tab, go to notis.ai and click start for free. Then you can put your phone number with your international prefix and click get started for free. Here just tells me that I have to use a plus instead of 00. There you go. And you're going to receive within a few seconds, you're going to receive a message directly on WhatsApp from Notis. There you go. Just got it here. Hey, I'm Notis, your AI employee. Let's get started with my onboarding, shall we? So just reply yes. Great, let's get started then. Which email should I use? I'm going to use my email. Don't hesitate to email me if you need anything. mindtheflow.com. Yes, I do have a Notion account already. And if you don't have, don't worry. I'll give you a link and you can subscribe to your Notion account there. And if you ever pay for Notion, then I'll get a little commission for it. All right, so here's the link to authorize my access to Notion, use the template, make sure to select use the template provided by the developer. I'll need this to work. That's an important step I'll show you. So I'm just going to click here, open a new tab in my browser, and here, click next, and here it's very important that you select use the template provided by the developer. This will install a template for Notis that contains multiple databases, like a whole system that you can use as a second brain out of the box. If you don't like it, you can always delete the database and the templates, but we'll get you a starting point and get you everything configured with Notis. And don't worry, you can add as many databases you want after. Notis is compatible with any templates, any database, so you can do that later. But if you're not sure what you're doing, start with this. For me, I know that I already have databases that are compatible with Notis, and I'll show you in later video how you can create those and configure those. So I'm going to select this. I just have two pages in my Notion, Notis and public, so I'm just going to allow access to Notis, validate, and what it's going to do right now is sync all databases, and specifically what are the fields, what are the databases that you have and so on. So the AI then knows when you record anything, which are the databases that are in your Notion, and then it can choose where to store the information and how to store it. Yeah, once the sync is completed, you'll see a list of all your databases. And here what you can do is activate or deactivate the ability of Notis to write inside your database. So what I'd recommend is to keep that number of activated database to a minimum. Really just keep activated the ones that you will want Notis to write. And What this enables is the AI to be much more precise in what you're asking it to do. So for example, I have an expense database where I want Notis to be able to create new expense, but I also have a budget database that is linked to my expense where I have my different categories for expenses. And I don't use Notis to create new categories. That's something that I do directly in Notion. So this is deactivated. Same thing, I have a project database and I don't use Notis to create new project, but I have tasks that are linked to projects and I use Notis all the time to create new tasks and new reminders. So this is activated. So you can just choose that here, and once you're happy, nothing more to do, it's automatically saved. You can just go back to Notis. And Notis will send you a confirmation. Hey, I just got access to your Notion. Great, can I call you Flo? And yes, this one will remember how to call me in the future. Wow, nice meeting you, Flo. Can I ask you what you do for a living? You're a creator. The mastermind behind the magic. One last thing, hotshot. Let's set up your free 7 days trial. And to claim that trial, we need your payment details. Don't worry, we can cancel it for free before your trial ends. So what you do from there, you just need to click here and select which of the subscription you're interested in. So we have two subscription. One, it's called Notis, and basically you get as many Notion documents as you want, works with text and voice. You get 1 hour of transcription per month, as many new templates on Notion that are generated with AI, unlimited conversations. What you get with the Pro is it also works with images. So you can send, for example, an image of your expense and it can recognize it's in there, or some notes that you took in a meeting and send it to Notis and ask it to transcribe it. It has unlimited voice transcription, so you can record meetings, for example, and you get everything else. You get also the reminders. You get the research assistant, so you can give it basically a Google search and it will look for it, and it's able to scrape website and get the content of it. And yeah, very importantly, you also get Q&A on your Notion documents, which means that we'll basically index everything in your Notion so it's available for the AI. So you can answer, for example, I have a note with the size of my minivan, and I can just ask Notis, what's the size of my minivan when I book my ferries tickets? And it will tell me exactly the size because it has access to everything that I shared on Notion with it. And you can sync as many databases as you want for this. So makes it an amazing tool to retrieve knowledge on the go out of your Notion document. All right. And so to activate your trial, what you'll just do is click start trial, put on all your information. And I'm not going to do that now. And it's going to give you a confirmation directly on Notis, send you a message like it did before that everything is set up. And there it is. I just got the message that confirmed me that my subscription is active. And from there, I can use Notis. Everything is set up. So let's make a try. Can you remind me tomorrow to finalize testing awesome Notis is? And so it's going to transcribe my voice message, understand that this is a task or a reminder, and it's going to understand it's tomorrow. It's going to look for my task and reminders database and save it directly there for me to use. And you can do this with any database. So I give you a few examples when you install the template, but let's say you want to create a client meeting database, you can do this and then you can summarize what a meeting with a client just was and it will save it there automatically. You can have a database for your expense and send it receipts and ask them to categorize it and extract all the information there. anything you can come up with, you can create directly in Notion and then have an awesome AI that can access it whenever you need it to write, but also organize and also ask questions about it. So the thing that makes Notis so awesome is that you can record voice message with really fuzzy thoughts, and it will take those fuzzy thoughts. It's going to reorder it and complete it and make it better. And then it's going to find the right place to save it. And depending on the place, it will change right it, because it understands in each database which fields you've configured. And so it's going to try to complete all of those. And if it has questions, we'll come back to you and ask for maybe some comments. And then it's going to save this information and this new Notion document there so that you can use it in Notion, but then you can also ask Notis later on a question about that document. Here, that's the demo effect. Just ask me that I'm not equipped for reminders because I took the basic plan. Let me just clarify and say, it's okay, you can just create a task. There you go. Let's just wait a minute that it creates that task. But that's everything for you to get started with Notis and experiment. How does it work with your existing workflow? And if you don't have a existing productivity workflow, feel free to use that base template that I've included with Notis. I think it's a great starting point for Notion. We all know, even like hardcore user knows, that Notion can be very intimidating at first, very overwhelming. So you need a place to get started. I think it's a very good place to get started. And then as you feel more comfortable with Notion, then you can start to make it fit exactly the way you want your productivity workflows to look like. There you go. Just got my task. I can click here. It will open my Notion in the right place. And it didn't spell Notis correctly, but it said this for tomorrow. That's correct. And the task is not started. And yeah, just get some basic task already defined for me. So give it a try. I'm here. If you need anything, you can ask Notis for my contact details. You also have this on the website. You can directly WhatsApp with me. And I'll be really happy to show you some tips and tricks. And please, any feedback that you have, super precious to me. So really don't hesitate to WhatsApp me as they come. You have a great day and talk soon. Cheers.